Hello YouTube, this is the Fat Guy, and I'm here with another video. As I said on my haul video from yesterday, I did end up going to my Monday Salvation Army for the collar rotation. And I got a ton of stuff. But since most of this video will be clothing, I'm going to break it off into the first part will be the non-clothing items I picked up, and I found some good non-clothing items. And then the rest, then right after that will be the stuff I paid ticket price for. And then everything past that will be 50 cent pieces. We'll see what, and you'll see what I got. I've got two large bags and a partial bag over here full of clothes. This will be a very long video. So let's go ahead and start with the non-clothing items. Today's half off sticker for their hard goods was orange, and in their case they had these both dead batteries, but they had these really nice Fossil watches. Of course they're a little scratched up and used, but still half off the original price, still a good deal. The first watch was a Fossil Kalido, nice little design. Its orange was at $2, so I paid $1 for that. The Kalidos don't seem to sell for a ton. I think like 20 and up on good condition. This is, you know, dead battery, so I may be listing this one for 15. Still not bad. This one is a Fossil Blue watch, orange tag at $4, so I paid $2. These sell for good money. I saw a lot of these similar blues go for like 30 plus. So that's a really good find. No battery. I don't have the kit. So I'm probably just going to list this one up for $20 as is, on, you know, $20 on this one, $15 on the other one, and get my good money out of it. You know, still good finds. You know, I paid $3 for both watches, and it'll net me easily a $20 profit, which is good because I spent a lot of money today. And by a lot, I mean everything you're going to see cost me a total of $56 out the door. No tax, but somebody showing me around here doesn't really charge tax. Next, I got this because of the brand. Art Mark three-piece bear salt pepper and toothpick holder set. This Art Mark, some of their stuff does well. I saw their frogs do well, and I guess it's just the idea of what's good on here. But I really don't know if this set will do well, but if I can list it for at least $10, I will. And it's a nice little set. Here's a little toothpick holder with a pink bow. And the salt and pepper shaker both have a blue bow, so they're the boys. And even the toothpicks that came with the set is new in the bottom, so I don't think the set was really used at all. So I'm probably only going to list it for like 10 bucks. It is first class, very light. I paid $1.50 for it. Pink tag, so I'm not half off. Still not that bad. We'll see how it goes on that set. I'm not big into salt and pepper shakers, but if I could find some and sell them for profit, I will. I really don't mind doing that. This next item was over there in their office supplies, and it is just a basic Brother P-Touch printer. I did plug it in. It did seem to work. There's no cassette, so I can't see if it prints out labels, but usually on these, you know, it still works. I saw a lot of these go for like 20 and up. I paid $3 for it. Yellow tag, so it wasn't a sale day for this collar. Still not bad. $3, even if I only sell it for like 25, I'm still going to make at least $10 profit off of it. So that's definitely not bad at all. Now, this item was a complete random find. I only looked this up because I know some watch bands are worth a lot, and this had a keyword on it that if you see on most things, it's expensive, and that's ostrich. I didn't know this brand. I didn't know anything about it. Here, let me remove it right quick. But I did do a quick search, and some of these watch bands sell for like 30 and up. This is a Chrysler R half ostrich calf watch band. Is really good condition. I flexed it. There was no breaking at all. This is not dry rotted at all. Very good condition. Probably never even been put on a watch. I did find it in this flex on watch case, but I do not know if that was its original case or not. And I do not know if this has ever been put on a watch. So I'm going to sell it as used, but still not bad. You know, I'll look up the solds and I'll look up the currents, but a lot of the currents were trying to get like through the moon prices. So I have no idea what I'm going to sell this for. I'm hoping at least $25 to $30 for it. And if you were wondering what I paid for it, I don't know if you can read that, but this watch band was $1.50. I was extremely happy about that. You know, it's a nice little haul of non-clothing items. Now let's get on to some of the clothing items I paid ticket price for. And I only bought two items at ticket price. This first item, I think this is a pleather. I didn't do much research on it, but it's a campus Korean made. I'm gonna call it pleather until I figure it out. Pleather jacket, nice condition, no cracks, no rips, no tears. Nice little snap front, you know, do not dry clean kind of tag. It's a size 38. I do not know if it's a man's or woman's. I'll do a little bit more research, but nice brown pleather jacket. I paid $2.50 for. I will gladly pay $2.50 for jackets. A lot of jackets I usually get about 20 and up for. So that's definitely a good find for me. This next item I got, and it's a wonderful looking piece. It is a older USA made Pendleton. Here, let me get you the tag. Size small, plaid kind of woman's top. It looks like a casual plaid top. It is woman's, but I paid $2 for this. I will gladly pay $2 for a vintage USA made Pendleton. Especially, you know, even though it's plaid, some of the stuff is really good. I like Pendleton. I like finding it. Always fun. I didn't want to wait on that to get to the 50 cent price. And I mean, seriously, it's $2. Not a lot to pay for a good looking Pendleton like that. Okay, now here's the mass haul of the 50 centers. Give me 1 minute. Okay, I'm just going to pull them out one at a time and show you what I got. And I'm not really going to know what I got till I pulled it out. Oh yeah, this one I just got because it was a red tag 50 center. It's a Chico's Design size 0 jean. I usually do Chico's, I don't do well with. You know, they're like $15 free shipping jean, which I don't mind if I'm paying 50 cents for it. But I like this design because at the cut, you know, at the bottom, it has this weird looking, you know, beaded kind of design on both of the bottoms. You know, really cool design. So maybe I can get a little bit more for these. I don't know. I'll look into it. But again, nice size 0 Chico design pants, 50 cents. Again, I don't mind making, you know, $5 to $10 a piece on these when I'm only paying 50 cents. Very little investment charge, very good return. Next. Okay, this was more of a gamble because I've never done much of Cherokee. But these look to be okay looking jeans. You know, these are size 12A women's or men's. They're probably just women's. 12A Cherokee blue jean, basic blue jean, 50 cent tag. These are, they look good. You know, even if I just list them for $14.99 free shipping, I'm still going to make money, so I'm happy about that. But again, those were just a pure gamble. When I saw them on the thing for 50 cents, I grabbed them. I didn't look them up. I didn't really look up any of this. I just grabbed them and went off my gut. And that next piece is a Z Carvacci size 12 pants. These are a youth or junior, probably. Never heard of Z Carvacci. Was made in United Arab. They're just nice little pants, you know, nothing special. Again, 50 cents, very light, so these will go first class. So even if I sell those for $9.99 free shipping, I'm happy, I make money. Next, I found a lot of these for some reason. And this one is a low-rise skinny Rue 21. Again, Rue 21, not the greatest brand, but I look, usually with jeans, if they're not a great brand, I look at the design. And these are a skinny, and not only are they a skinny, they're a low rise. And usually that kind of jean does well for me. So this is just a low rise skinny, Rue 21, size 9-10. So, you know, newer brand, not bad, dark wash, you know, really good looking pair of jeans, 50 cents. I am happy about that. Next is another pair of jeans. Here, I'll put that one down. Pair of jeans right here. This one, just a basic Calvin Klein, size 7. Calvin Klein size 7 jean. If I find most Calvin Klein stuff for 50 cents, I'll grab it. You know, not the greatest thing. But even if I get something for 15 to 20 bucks, I'm happy. Let's start with this piece down here that I threw out that got caught with the jeans. This is just a basic athletic pant, but it's from a company called Green Tea. Never heard of them, size medium, 50 cents for an athletic pant. Really light, goes first class. I'm kind of happy about that. Next was another 50 cent. Okay, all these are 50 centers. I'm not going to repeat 50 centers. So I'm just going to show you what I got. So everything is just 50 cents. I'm not repeating it. I'm getting tired of repeating it. I'm sorry, guys. I'm sorry, but it's just the way it is. Next is this Coca-Cola red shirt. Nothing fancy. Coca-Cola brand, size large, you know, good for the price. Next, I picked up a Scott Barber Made in Hong Kong large front button, and I believe this is a man's. Yeah, this is a man's. You know, just a nice striped Hong Kong made front button, you know, very lightweight, first class. If I listed for $9.99 in sales, I make about $5, so I'm happy. Next is a Cotton Traders large, kind of knit, or, you know, kind of a little ornate sweater. Really cool design, has geometric designs on the striped front. But again, it's not that fancy, but we'll see what it sells for. I gambled on it because it was 50 cents, so we'll see what happens. Another piece I got that I really liked, even though it's basic, just an Island Shores. I think this is a men's front button Island Shore shirt. Again, I really don't know if this was good. I just saw it for 50, you know, for the price and just grabbed it. Here's another one. Arnold Palmer Polo, you know, good 50 cent shirt. Lightweight, you know, those all go first class. So if it goes first class, I sell for at least 10, I'm happy. Here's a red front button J. Farrar. Front button shirt, looks to be in good condition. Again, not bad. Another one I got just because it was the cheap price this is a Galeo front button men's, really weird looking. It's like brown or orange. It's like a multicolor. When you shine a light on, it's really cool. Next is a Yusum style medium top jacket, or whatever you want to call it. It looks nice. It is a woman's. It has a class style closing system. I'll look it up, but we'll see if it sells or not. Again, I'm not upset. You know, 50 cents is 50 cents. Here's just another front button stripe J. Farrar front button. If I can get front buttons for 50 cents, I like to get most brands, because I can usually list them for $9.99 and mail them first class. It's not really a headache. If they're a cheaper brand, of course. Next is this really nice one. It's a Jolt jacket. This is large. It's deep purple. Nice design. I don't know if you can really get that. Size small from Jolt. Has a bunch of these weird buttons on the front. And over here as well. Really good piece. Really heavy. But it feels good. It looks good. 50 cents. I'm happy. Another one, again, these are probably not, this is going to be another like $9.99 shirt. This is just a Dreamland Hawaiian style shirt. Good collar, good flowers, front button, men's. So we'll see what happens on that. Here's another one of those cheaper Hawaiian style shirts I get. This is a Puritan, so it's probably $9.99. I'll probably even take probably $7.99 on them, you know, just to get them out of the house. Just a men's floral Hawaiian style surf style shirt. Again, not bad for what I paid for it. Next is a, I got this because the design was a little weird. It is a Corret Francisca jacket. And it's just got a bunch of like fish and seashells and starfish. You know, it's really cool, weird looking design. Front zip. Again, not bad for the price. We'll see what I can sell it for. This one I got because I really like the liner. I mean, the jacket doesn't look that great. It was just brown, basic brown, but it pops with this leopard print collar. It is from Energy. I really don't see a size tag. Oh, here, it's small. So size small, brown, leopard print. Really funky. I like it. Next is a... Oh, this is just a cheaper brand, but I got it because it was Arizona. I didn't get it because it was Arizona, but I got it because, you know, it's just 50 cents. Just Arizona jacket for youth. Solid black, nice puffer. I know it's getting out of the season, but I still like getting them. Especially for that price. Next, I got a... this is a blast from the past. Circuit City Polo. And it is Circuit City brand. And I like this. I just got it because it's like, why not? You know, I don't see Circuit City stuff all that often. And I had one here in town years and years ago. And it shut down years and years ago. So I like picking weird stuff up like that. You know, if I ever find Blockbuster or something like that, I'll probably always pick it up. And it's kind of a bonus when you get it for 50 cents. Here is a Live a Little, LAL. Nice little red jacket. It has a really cool design on it. It's button up the butt. Really cool design. Nice closure system where it's just a pop closure system. Size small. Really nice jacket. I like it. We'll see what it sells for. I really don't know. Most of these, I don't know if they're going to sell or what they'll sell for. But I'm going to make my money back regardless, so I'm happy anyway. This other one's not the greatest brand, and it's just basic brown, but I got it for 50 cents. It's been up there for weeks, and I've seen this up there a couple times. And I thought about getting it, but I thought might as well just wait. And it's a Juicy Couture, just a solid brown, you know, hooded jacket kind of thing. Some of their stuff sells okay. Some of their stuff does not. You never know. We'll see what happens. Next is a... I've got to find the front. Oh, here it is. This is just a Relativity size small woman's jacket. Really weird design. Just a basic jacket. We'll see if it sells. Really cool. Really felt good. Next is another gamble I got. And that's... And that is a Haberdasbury USA-made two-piece pantsuit for woman. It is a pantsuit. It's basic gray, but it is an older style one. You know, USA, size 18, two-piece for, I think, 50 cents. If not, I paid a dollar for it because it's like 50 cents a piece on the set. So we'll see if what that sells for. Next is this rather nice... hoodie. It's just from Affy Sport. It's a petite extra large blue white kind of sports style jacket, zip style. Again, it's just nice active wear. I always like picking up some active wear when I can. Speaking of active wear, I know this is branded for UTPB basketball, but I couldn't let it go. It's just it's an Adidas Klima 365 kind of track style athletic wear. Really cool jacket. Next is just a basic t-shirt from St. John's Bay. I don't like getting St. John's Bay, but once in a while I do. This is a really cool floral writing design. Again, $7.99, $8.99, $9.99. We'll see what I can sell it for. So it's not too bad. Next. Oh, yeah, this is another big jacket. This is a Dry Dock by Serban. It's an exclusive rainwear. A big, long, black rainwear jacket. Again, 50 cents. Love it. And remember, we're still not through the first bag yet. So here's some more. Here's some more I got. It's a Southern Lady large jacket. I just like the design. You know, it's little lines up here, metal buttons, really good quality feel to it. Southern wear is usually fun. And we'll see what happens with it. Next is an Adriana Papel. I sometimes sell these, sometimes I don't. It just depends on the day. But just a simple dark purple, kind of weird. It's really hard to pick up on my camera, but it has some of these weird line look to it. It looks nice. 50 cents, I'll take it. Next, I got for 50 cents, and that's basically because it was 50 cents. It's an Excursion purple, weird looking top. I believe this may be an activewear style top, but still, I like it. We'll see what I can get rid of it for. Next was a really nice looking Sugar Lips, size small, just a basic blue green dress with a really low cut on the front. You know, really light. This would probably still go first class. And it's still, you know, really good for what I paid for it. Next is a just my size. Usually I don't do well with these, but I got this because of this. It's a simple red kind of sweater style sleeveless top or over top with a really cool like leathery circle design right here. That's what drew my eye to it. You know, it looks like something casual that would add a little flair to an outfit. Really cool. So we'll see what it sells for later. Next I got, I believe it's another dress. This one's from California Concepts, made in Mexico, but it's a nice little blue green abstract tie back dress, really long, really light. Again, probably another first class package. Next is a simple, oh wait, no, this ain't simple. This, I'm gonna call this a jumper, but it's a Tommy Jeans medium jumper. It looks like someone did cut off the legs, which I think will probably add to the appeal to it. But it's a front zipper, it's one piece, it's a really cool, feels great. It looks like it's a fit, you know, older, like 90s style maybe. I don't know the styles from then. Next is just a basic teamwork baseball pants. Got these, 50 cents. They're a really big pair. Their size, I really don't know. 36 to 38, so not as big as I thought. But still pretty good, pretty clean. Not bad for the price. Next, Buffalo Station. If it wasn't for that weird name, I probably wouldn't have got this. But just a Buffalo Station jacket, little buns up at the top, basic gray, double pocket. And no idea what that will sell for, but I will gladly gamble for that price. That's one piece. Next, and sorry I'm a little out of breath, is a speckless or speechless size large dress. This has like a rope tie shoulders with a really cool stripe multicolor design to it. You know, top black, really long. This feels like it would be really flowy, really casual, really feels like it's really good quality. Again, I don't do speckless or speechless. I don't do a lot of that because it's usually cheaper stuff. I just sold one of their dresses for like $9.99. Free shipping, so I pay 50 cents for it. I sell it for around that. That one I'll probably try to get a little bit more because it's a little bit better than what the other one was. So we'll see what happens. Sorry, I've got to dig in this bag now. We're getting low on it. We're almost done with the first bag, thank God. Next, just a Lands End medium, like, windbreaker style jacket, dark blue. Again, not bad. I just buy most of the stuff mainly because of the style, size, or price. And because a lot of these are 50 cents, I don't mind gambling away that money. Next, these were nice. It's like a tan, khaki style denim Levi 550 relaxed fit jeans. These are a woman's size 14M. So it's a 14 medium, I believe. Relaxed boot cut Levi's. I will gladly pick up this kind of Levi for 50 cents. I love Levi's. I love selling Levi's. They're always fun. Next is a Lee's Signature. I usually don't pick up Levi's Strauss signatures. But for the 50 cents, I'm going to gamble on it. But it's a basic 3130s. 3130 regular fit Levi Strauss. You know, nice dark, you know, nice blue jean. Next, another jeans. I know I picked up a lot of jeans. This one's just a low rise cropped gap stretched. Some gap I do okay with, but I got this because the design on it, you know, it's a low rise cropped pair of jeans. You know, it's faded a little bit, distressed a little bit. You know, it's trendy. It'll probably sell for okay money. We'll see what it goes for. Next, again, mainly only got because it was 50 cents, was Tommy Hilfiger pair of jeans. These are a size, sorry, I'm going to have to hunt it down. Size 12, so they're probably a woman's Tommy Hilfiger jean. So not too bad for the price. Next, I have, oh yeah, this is just a basic top. It's from Avenue, and it's just slightly embellished. It's not bad. It has some of this cool little designs up top, nice white buttons, so we'll see what it sells for. Don't know if I can get much for it, and that's the end of the first bag. Second bag. Like I said, this is going to be a very long video. Very first item. It's just a day trip sheer abstract top. Usually if I can find something like this for this low, I love getting it. It's a semi-sheer because you can see somewhat through it, but not completely. Nice abstract, very lightweight. So it's a light top. I usually like picking up stuff like that. It's usually really fun. Next, I got a Allison Taylor tiger striped little top. I believe this is like a nightgown top, but Allison Daily, really light, really nice, good shimmer to it. Or it's a little shimmery, so it's pretty cool. Next, I'm trying to go through a lot of this for you. It's a Countess Wara, size large, I believe. This may be a man's. Never heard of Countess Wara. But just a basic front button stripe design with some weird pattern inside the stripes. So we'll see what the heck that sells for. I have no idea. Next. Oh yeah, this was pretty nice. I like this one. Izod large. Nice heavy sweater. You know, it's kind of brown. It is Izod. Even has a little Izod emblem here. Good for 50 cents. I'm surprised I get most of these for 50 cents. Because, you know, it's just strange. But I think most people go to Salvation Army around here, buys for themselves and not for what I do. So it's usually good for me. I really like it. Then I got in a size large apartment 9, kind of flowy, butterfly, embellished, or whatever you call it with the little jewels attached. I got it not because of the brand, but the design. You know, it's nice, it's colorful, it's light. I can see someone wearing that, you know, at home when they're relaxing or slightly out with something under it. It's really nice. And then I got this next one mainly because of the name. Don't Mess With Texas. I love this brand. Some of it does well, some of it does not, but this is a simple blue pearl snap style shirt. You know, it's really good. I've got to figure out if that's a man's or a woman's, but we'll look into it later. Next one is just a Felis or Fila sweater, jacket, whatever you want to call it. You know, emblemed. I like it. 50 cents. Not going to cry. Next, I got this is a lighter piece that I think I only threw in here because it was 50 cents, but it's a very kind of washed out floral vest. No idea if this will sell, but we'll see. Next, it's just a boot cut Cope Semi Avance Cherokee. Again, Cherokee, not the best, but 50 cents, I'll take it. Next, oh yeah, I got this because the design on the cup front. Sorry, I've got to find the top. This is a Tara zipper kind of sweater, and it's full of these very colorful flowers. The back is just a basic blue, but on the front is these, you know, yellows, browns. It feels fally, it feels nice, it's really heavy, good made. So we'll see what it sells for. Next, I got this one because of the design, not the brand. It's a Gloria Vanderbilt, like a leafy, beaded, written top, you know, nice, stylish. It looks good. Somebody will definitely wear it. Next, I got a... Sorry, I'm getting a little winded here because it's so much. So much. I've got to find this. Oh, yeah, this was a Ralph Lauren black blue knit sweater. Nice. Well, I love Lauren, or whatever you call him. I love his stuff. Most of it sells okay for me. I like it. Some of it sells, some of it don't, but some of it's really cool. Next, I got mainly because it's just simple athletic pants. It's OSU Cowboys Red Oak athletic pants. And it was just really cool add-on down there. You know, 50 cents, I'll take it. Next is a nice, light, flowy... This is a Reba. I usually don't buy Reba too, but this design, this beautiful, beautiful design, you know, it's kind of reddish, has flowers and leaves. It's really cool, really light. It feels good. We'll see what it goes for. Next, I got a woman's pinstripe, Ralph Lauren pinstripe pants. Again, pinstripe is cool. I don't know if these women's pinstripes will sell, but Lauren, Ralph Lauren, why not? I didn't pay that much for it, and I'm happy. Next is a just a Mary-Kate and Ashley. I think these are used jeans. They got metal studs up here on the top, and then here at the bottom, they have this really cool design. Again, I'm gambling on them, but we'll see. But again, I'm not upset. Next, this was another one I was glad to find for 50 cents. Levi 550 women's size 12 miss black denim jeans. And if you do a lot of women's jeans, if you do mainly jeans and all, you know some people really love color jeans. Black is a good color that a lot of people look for. And getting those for 50 cents is a bonus. Hell, if those were my size and they were men's, I'd keep them. Because I love black jeans. I love black jeans. Next is just a simple... top. It is a good little looking. It is from Feline, but I got it mainly because it is a cool floral design with this blue kind of front. I don't know what they call that. Maybe a knit style. I don't know, but it just adds a little bit of, you know, good look to the piece. I really, really like finding those. Hold on. I've got to move my legs so they're not cramping no more. And then let's continue. Next, I do not know who made these. Give me 1 minute to find out. Okay, I don't know who made them. They're Gap. Okay, these are Gap. The button here says 1969 Gap, but I got them mainly because of the look of the jean. They're long and lean. Always do well with long and lean. They're a size 6L, basic blue, semi-distressed blue jean. Again, I picked up a lot of jeans. It's going to get warmer, so some people maybe were looking for more jeans to add to their closet. I wear jeans year-round, so I love picking them up when I can for cheap. Next is just a classic fit Nautica, you know, jean, you know, basic blue jean. Again, nothing too exciting there, but we'll see if it sells or not. Next is a woman size 14 Izod, really weird looking desire dress, office wear pants, you know, 50 cents, I'm happy. Next, and I know I said I wasn't going to keep repeating it, sorry, just in my head. Next I got Smith's, made in Sri Lanka, 14, size 14, really short jean, you know, they're kind of really short. They got a really cool design here on the back pocket. Again, I'm not upset. We'll see if they sell. If they don't, I can always put them in the yard sale and sell them that way. Next is a Rue 21 jean. I got this for a few reasons. One, the collar. Nice, dark purple. Second reason I got these was that they were a skinny fit. Third and fourth reason I got these were the button here is really cool designed. And if you look here in the back, up here in the pockets, they have these square studs. And they are a silver or a chromish kind of black. Still, really like those. Good price. Good deal. Okay, now this is the end of the second bag. Woo! This is another item that's been up there for a couple weeks, and I haven't bought it yet because it is branded. I don't like buying stuff like this is branded because they do settle a little bit. But finally, today, at the 50 cent a day, I had to get it. Nike Dry Fit, I think this is a track style, athletic style jacket. It is for UFIS, the college in town, cross country, nice jacket, good 50 cent deal. Ooh. Now give me 1 minute and I'll hunt down the last bag. We are already at about 35 minutes in this video. Sorry it's taken so long, but I bought a ton of stuff today. So let's continue. And the last bag is very light, so there's not going to be too many pieces in here, I hope. Next, just a simple design. Writing with a nice little artistic owl on it. This is from Billabong. I just got it mainly because of the design. I don't know Billabong. I don't know the brand, but I love the design. And usually for me, the design will sell the piece more than the... On something like that, it'll be the design people mostly look for, unless Billabong is a good brand. Next is just a simple Janssen sweater. Just acrylic, you know, multicolored style sweater. Nothing fancy. Next is a simple NCAA OSU shirt. Again, these don't sell for a ton and they usually sit, but I'm still kind of happy to get them. Now this next piece is a men's, I believe, but I got this because of the weird coloration. I believe this is a man's. It is from the company Roberto Villani. It's 100% cotton, made in Korea, size 17. But it's a weird kind of orangey brown. Depending on the light, when you shine this in light, it turns into two different colors. That just drew my attention to it right then and there. It's a weird color combination, and it looks nice, it feels nice. You know, even at $10 sale, if that is as cheap as it will go, then I will put lowest, I'll put it on. It'll just nice, and I'll see if I can sell it. I know I'm rambling, I'm sorry, but this has been, day just started, and I'm already semi-tired. Next is just a simple 100% linen, Tommy Bahama, nothing too fancy. Shirt, glad to get it for 50 cents, but I probably wouldn't pay no more for that because those are getting flooded, and that's just a basic Tommy Bahama, so that will be even cheaper than most of the other Bahamas. Oh, next is just Gap. Again, I've been trying to branch into this. Depending on the clothing, I usually go for the design over the brand on Gap, but this is a nice, feels almost like a denim, you know, almost a jean jacket kind of deal, with a nice big metal buttons that do kind of remind me of jeans. So this may be a denim jean jacket. Red, girls, women's, size small, Gap jacket. Really good piece for the price. Next, I went ahead and grabbed this Banana Republic. That one mainly because of the brand. You know, I usually can get like $8-$10 out of these. Simple blue pocket tee. That's all it is. It has a little frill design around the neck, and that's about it. Ooh. Next, I got this one because it's very colorful, very looking. It's a improved living, kind of like a lined or innered, innered top. It's colorful. Blues, reds, greens mixed with black. Oh, it's very colorful, very light. You know, it's nice, little casual. Here, let me get this up there for you. You know, it's a beautiful piece. I don't know if that's a great brand or not, but I had to get it for the design. You know, 50 cents, I'm happy. Next, never heard of this people, Blackjack. I have not heard of that brand yet. But I got this because of the design. It's kind of like a short sleeve hooded shirt. I do not know if it's a man or woman's yet. I will look it up. But it's got some of these nice pearl snap style buttons along with a hooded shirt. Two pockets on the front that are clasped with pearl snaps. You know, classic style mixed with modern design, and I like stuff like that. You know, that's probably gonna go to some teenager who really wants it, and they will rock that. That's a good looking piece. If I had something that size, I probably would not have worn it when I was younger because I was a fat kid, so that kind of stuff would not look good on me, but it's a really cool piece. Next is a Aeropostale stretch medium, basic pink top. This is basic pink Aeropostale shirt. Cool little design with the buttons at the top, but that's about it. Nothing special, nothing exciting, but again, I'll probably list it for $9.99. Now here's a cool looking piece. This is a Fiorlini International. I don't know the size. The size tag torn off and I didn't see that in the store. So I'm going to measure this and do a Google search for sizes. Nice kind of gold floral design. Has leaves, flowers, and stuff on top. Very light, very... it feels really good. I don't know how to really tell, but really good feel to it. It's kind of stylish. I can see someone wearing that, you know, to the coffee shop, out on the town, you know, doing their errands, stuff. That's a nice casual semi-dress-up shirt that'll make people look at you twice and be like, wow. Next is just a simple Harmony style top. This is a semi, or this has holes in it, so I don't know if that would be a sheer or not. But I'm going to call it semi-sheer. Harmony, small, USA made shirt or sweater top or something. Really light, really cool. I mainly got it because the design's really nice. It feels good and it's made in the USA. I love USA made clothing. Next, it's just a simple Karen Scott's top. It does have some nice little ornate floral designs, but beyond that little bit and on the sleeves, this does not have much to say to it, but I got it mainly because of that reason. Nice, casual, with some flair to it. You know, people will look at this and be like, oh, that's pretty, and that's really good looking. I think it's good looking. I don't know if other women would think it's good looking, and I'm not a woman. But I have been told that I have somewhat okay style in that kind of clothes. And I don't dress myself up at all. I wear t-shirts and jeans. Next is just this Jack Nicholas jacket. I got it mainly because of that. Heavy duty, heavy set, more like an athletic style or just top. Long sleeve, semi-zip. It's just a partial zip that goes up to the neck. Again, black, basic, Jack Nicholas, 50 cents. I love it. Ooh, we're getting down to the last bit. Next is just another one I got because of the price tag. Men's Mex front button stripe shirt, multicolored stripe. Now, I got this because it looked cool. You know, multicolored shirt, really lightweight. Again, if it's only a $10 shirt, it's a $10 shirt. Next, another front button I got. This is a men's Dockers medium. Simple Dockers red squared front button shirt. You know, nice casual shirt. Dockers is okay brand. They're not fancy, but they do sell for a little bit. You know, I could probably list this for like 10 to 12 bucks and sell it. And it's just a nice casual shirt that some guy will probably be happy to get. And this is our last piece for this haul. And someone starched this. Someone did something to it. But anyway, this is just another basic front button Nautica. This is just Nautica, but it does have the vintage Oxford style. Men's front button, casual tan look to it. You know, it looks nice. One pocket, good classic design. We'll see if it sells. If it don't, it can go straight back into a bag and go down to Savers to be redonated. But again, classic fit, Hong Kong made Nautica shirt. Good brand. I mean, they're okay, but they have that classic flair that some guys still look for. Classic, you know, one pocket front button shirt that you can wear around town. You can even, you know, if you dress up in this and just put on a pair of jeans and some good shoes, you can easily go to the bar with this and go out like that. Just, that's all they really need, you know, just a simple shirt. And that is our major haul for today. I know I rambled. I'm very sorry about that. I know I kept talking on and on. But as you saw, we got a bunch today. Everything you saw in this video was only $56. And I am definitely going to get my money back. I have a large pile over here off camera of all those clothes now that I'm gonna have to go through, picture, measure. You know the hassle. Fun getting it. Pain in the butt to list, but that's where we get our money. So everybody, have a great day. This is the Fat Guy, and I am off for now.